Hello friends, I am Dr. Sandeep Goyal. I am working as a senior consultant in Department of Psychiatry, SPS Hospitals, Ludhiana. Today we will discuss obsessive compulsive disorder, which is also known as OCD. OCD is characterized by the presence of obsessions and compulsions. Obsessions are recurrent thoughts, images, or urges. Thoughts, for example, contamination, images like seeing violent or sexual scenes, or urge to hit someone. These obsessions are not pleasurable and provoke anxiety in an individual. Obsessions are recognized as intrusive and unwanted. An individual tries to ignore or suppress these obsessions or to neutralize them with another thought or action, for example, by performing a compulsion. Compulsions are repetitive behaviors, for example, washing or checking, or mental acts, for example, counting or prayers, which have to be performed by an individual to neutralize anxiety caused by obsessions. Compulsion too are not pleasurable, but the individual feels better as compulsions reduce anxiety caused by obsessions. 12-month prevalence internationally is 1.1 to 1.8%. In childhood, males are more affected, whereas in adults, females are affected slightly more than males. Etiology. Abnormality of the serotonergic system, particularly hypersensitivity of the postsynaptic 5-HT receptor, is the main hypothesis. However, the potential role of dopamine is also emerging. The neurobiological explanation of OCD focuses on aberrant functioning of corticostriatal thalamic cortical circuit. Now we will discuss about the symptoms of OCD. Most of the patients have both obsessions and compulsions, and the patient may have a mental compulsion rather than behavioral compulsions. For example, prayers after blasphemous thoughts. Some patients may have only obsessions without compulsions. The obsessions and compulsions are ego alien, that is, they are perceived as foreign to one's experience of oneself. Contamination is the most common type of the obsession, followed by increased hand washing or other rituals like more time spent in taking a bath, washing the already washed clothes or utensils, washing of currency notes, or avoidance of the object. The patient can have skin lesions due to excessive hand washing. Pathological doubts are the second most common type of obsession, and it includes frequent checking of the door or frequent counting of the money. Intrusive thoughts are obsessive thoughts without a compulsion. For example, thoughts of an aggressive or sexual act. Obsession of symmetry or precision is the next common obsession, which leads to slowness. Patient takes hours to complete a simple task, for example, dressing up. Obsession of symmetry leads to the delayed completion of the school or work projects because the projects never feel just the right. The patient with obsession about symmetry may also have magical thinking, which means patient has thinking that if my toys are not arranged symmetrically, my mom will die. And he arranges his toys in a symmetry to prevent harm to her mother. Compulsions are not linked to fear consequences realistically. For example, arranging items symmetrically will not prevent harm to the family members. This is known as magical thinking. To diagnose OCD, as per Diagnostic and Statistical Manual 5th Revision, the obsession and compulsion must consume more than 1 hour per day or cause impairment in the social, occupational, or other important areas of functioning. In OCD, usually the patient have good insight and recognize that their OCD beliefs are not true. But some patients have poor insight and think that their OCD beliefs are probably true. Rarely patients have no insight and think that their OCD beliefs are true. Yale Brown Obsessive Compulsive Scale is considered the gold standard for assessing the severity of OCD symptoms. Differential diagnosis. Other obsessive spectrum disorders, major depressive disorder, anxiety disorders, Tourette syndrome, obsessive compulsive personality disorder, and medical disorder like Sydenham's chorea, Huntington's disease are common differential diagnoses. Sometimes it is difficult to distinguish OCD with poor insight from psychotic disorders. Treatment. Treatment includes a combination of pharmacotherapy and psychotherapy, and results of combined pharmacotherapy and psychotherapy produce better results as compared to either of these used alone. SSRIs or clomipramine is the first line of treatment, and among SSRIs, fluoxetine, sertraline, citalopram, paroxetine, and fluvoxamine are approved by US FDA for the treatment of OCD in adults. Among TCAs, clomipramine is approved for treatment of OCD and is the most selective for serotonin reuptake among TCAs. Glutaminergic agents like NMDA receptor blocker drugs like memantine have shown benefit in patients with OCD in small uncontrolled studies. Other glutaminergic modulating agents like riluzole and topiramate have shown benefit in OCD, but none of the drugs acting on glutamate are FDA approved yet. Regarding psychotherapy, exposure and response prevention is the main behavioral approach. Desensitization, thought stopping, and flooding are also used in OCD. ECT is the oldest neuromodulation technique, and for severe treatment resistant cases, ECT can be considered. Deep brain stimulation, DBS, is FDA approved for disabling OCD not responding with other less invasive treatments. And for extreme debilitating cases which are not responding to any treatment, psychosurgery has been tried with varying results. Thank you.